Welcome to tutorial number 4 on drawing the kitchen. All right, let's put a countertop on this bank of cabinets here. Now, we could use the countertop tool, which is this guy right here. But I think what we'll do is we'll just draw a rectangle. And I have measured the distance from the refrigerator panel to the pantry. Actually, we don't even need to measure. We can just pull it down here. It's 162 9/16. And I'm going to make it 25 1/4 deep. And I'm going to extrude it to 1.5 inches. And take a look, see where it's sitting. Gonna move it up 34.5. All right, now we have to put a sink in it. I wanted to use a Kohler sink that doesn't have a it has unequal size compartments in it. So what I did for you and for me was I created a symbol for the cutout in the countertop that will allow the sink to sit right down over this. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to go to the resource browser, and what you want to do is look in your resource browser. Let me see if it's in here as well. It should be. Yes, here it is right here. If you look under symbols, here's your symbols and plug-in objects. You'll see this K3150 sink cutout. Just select that and pull it in and place it. Now, I didn't worry about putting it right into place. I'm going to do that now. Just move it back, and I'm going to nudge it back just a little bit. Now, it's already a 3D object. So, I'm going to select it. I'm going to select the countertop, and I'm going to subtract solid. You know what I should do before I do that? Let me double check and make sure where that came in. See if that's sitting down on the bottom as well. No, it looks good. It looks like it's just right. Okay, great. So select it, select the countertop, and go to model, subtract solid. I want to subtract it from the countertop, and now we should have a nice cut out there for our sink. Let's take a look. Look at that. You can see right through the countertop. Okay, wonderful. Now we can put the sink in. So now we will go to our resource browser and back to our favorites and go to, let's see, sanitary Kohler sinks. And the one that I chose was this one right here. Okay, there it is. Let's take a look again in 3D. Oh, came in down on the floor, so let's move it up 36 inches. Since the countertop is now 36. Now let's look. Ah, beautiful. It's a beautiful thing. Okay, now we've got our sink done and we are looking good. Well, now that we have our sink in, we should probably put a faucet in. So let's do that. Let's go back up to our favorites. Let's find sanitary Kohler faucets for kitchens. And we'll pick one out here. And I think I want something relatively contemporary. Now, some of these, I want to point this out to you. Notice down here that we have some faucets. These are 2D elements. And notice this little 2 right here tells you that it's a 2D symbol. These are both 2D and 3D. That's one of the really neat things about Vectorworks is that these symbols, they're called hybrid symbols in that they show themselves up in one way in 2D, and then they actually look different in 3D. And as an example, the door here is an example. It displays itself as you would expect to see it in a working drawing. And yet when you go to the 3D drawing, the door is closed and you see the panel and it has a different look. So these are hybrid symbols. So let's just pick one of these. I don't know. How about this? Do this goofy looking thing here. Bring that in. I'm going to put it right there. And then we'll take a little closer look and see if we can move it around. All right, there we go. Let's look at it in 3D. Actually, let's look at it in front view. I have a feeling it's down on the floor. Oh, look at that. It's down in the shelf down here. So I'll move it up. Get in a little closer so I can actually see if I've got it on the right level, and I don't. I'm just going to nudge it up now. Now let's take a look at it in 3D. All right. Yeah, that's pretty cool looking. Okay. Now it's time to put in our wall cabinets. And I'm going to leave that up to you. I'm going to let you put the wall cabinets in. Pay attention to the nomenclature that is given on the drawing that I gave you. And also notice that they have the prairie-style doors on them. Also, make sure that you get the grain aligned vertically. And also pay attention to choosing cabinets and possible fills or a fill that will get the distance between this window trim and the cabinet the same on both sides. All right, well, I hope you have fun doing this, and I'll see you in just a little bit. All right, the next thing I want you to do is to draw a polygon, and you can see the outline of the polygon right here that I carefully drew around the window and up underneath the base cabinets, and it comes to the side. It looks like it goes through this cabinet, but it actually just comes to the edge of the pantry cabinet, comes back down and back around. You're going to extrude it to a 16th of an inch. Basically what it's going to do is give you a 3D surface to which you can apply a fill or a texture. And that texture is going to be some sort of tile or granite or something. You can do what you want back there, but make sure you get that done. Okay? And then finally, you're going to create a floor and a ceiling surface. All right? So basically, I just zoomed out, made the floor larger than I needed it to be, and I kept playing with it until I got it large enough so that when I showed this 3D perspective view, it covered the entire screen. All right, and I did the same thing with the ceiling. So basically, you're going to go into a plan view, draw a rectangle for the floor, make sure it's on the ground plane, Give it an extrusion of a 16th of an inch. Make it bigger than you need because you're not going to see behind it. And then you're also going to draw a rectangle for the ceiling. And the ceiling is going to be up, of course, at 96 inches, which is our wall height. you'll also draw it larger than what you need, extrude it to a 16th of an inch, and then on both of them, give them a texture that you like. You can go in and use one of the marmoleum floors, or you can do what I did. I used concrete just to do something a little different. And then I used the dark bamboo on the ceiling. Now, nothing is, I haven't done any lighting at this point. So that's why the ceiling is darker than the sides of the cabinets here. There's no reflected light on them. And, well, I guess that's about it. Why don't you get that done, and then we'll come back, and we will light this kitchen. All right, see you soon.